Are you interested in deep diving technology? Are you interested in ball fury? One of those very easy to just absorb and just let it play on the side and just, you know, you can go along and follow through. Do you want something that's light and very cheesy and very relaxing to just absorb and you're like, oh yeah, I know this. And also, do you fall into the criteria of an RPG enthusiast? So meaning if you play WoW or FF14 or something along those lines, because if you do and you're interested, I have the perfect little manhwa for you. And it is called Archmage Dreamer! Yeah! What's going on, everyone? This is Empress ZK, and I realized that for a while I haven't been releasing any of my manhwa manga and manhwa talks a little bit here and there, so I do apologize for that, but I tell you what, this week we are going to be doing a lot of double releases, if not triple releases, if I get the chance, because I have now gotten myself into a proper working groove and getting the editing out is just so much more simpler. All right, so guys, let's quickly get into this one. I have to really say I've been holding back on this one because, you know, this is one of those ones that I really like to just keep on refreshing, keep on thinking, oh, yeah, you know, when's the next chapter going to be released? But I'll tell you what, Archmage Dreamer is one of those manhwas that I don't typically really understand to begin with, right? Because, you know, you're thinking deep dive, you're like, ah, yeah, I don't really care too much about it because I've got my SAO, I've got my Fury, I've got all these kind of different kind of deep divers that I'm already into. But then, you know, what makes Archmage Dreamer so much more easy to read is its relatability, right? Because in these kind of games that, you know, they deep dive, it's all about, you know, exploitation of adventures, getting rewards, getting quests and all that, and getting those kind of things to identify. But what if I told you that the creator of this story also was arrogant, you know, just like how SAO was? He started with this and says, you know what, I don't really care, but when you guys do find the storyline, you'll find the storyline, and that's exactly what's gonna happen, right? And so everyone goes into it, and the first thing that you immediately notice is that the main protagonist that you will pretty much likely forget his name, because his name is Hyunwoo, right? But you'll relate to him as Archmage Dreamer, because that is the title. That is just basically what he's going to be referred as the whole time, because he likes to keep himself anonymous. But the beginning, right, with all these kind of stories, is that he actually, you know, hates the game, right? He's absorbed into that toxicity, he's absorbed into the bad luck, right? Because the game, to begin with, it's all about gacha. Right, you don't know what you're going to be picking, you don't know what class you're going to be picking, you have no control of it, and you do what you do. Each time you pull and pick and restart, it's going to cost you about $800 something, and that is quite crazy as a game, but apparently it is the number one thing, it is the norm, right? So we do go into the game right there, and then, you know, obviously the character that he has is a mage, and you know, class mage and class spells and all that, all your skills are pulled randomly, all the things that you get is random, and of course when you go and fight, you're pretty much underpowered and you need to be in a guild and yada 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 yada, you know. However, there are people who are super lucky to get really amazing classes, really amazing skills, really amazing itemization, and always finding these kind of different kind of things that he just can't, you know, barely catch up to, because the main character, Archmage Dreamer himself right here, he's pretty much, you know, a regular you and me, when we do start a new game, when it's already been out for a few years and we've been playing it, but we're just not that lucky, right? We haven't got those lucky encounters, and we just start hating at people who constantly streams and constantly gets all this amazing stuff and gear, and you're like, why doesn't it happen to me, right? We're like, here, you know, he's like one of us, very easily relatable, and we, you know, give credits to this kind of little beautiful place. But then what happens right after is that as all good isekai stories come out, Truck-kun comes out of nowhere and misses him. Right? It doesn't happen. He goes, oh man, almost got his isekai'd right there. It did not happen. But what happened is that he got electrocuted instead, because he hit the truck-kun, hits the electric pole, and then the pole falls down, and then, you know, because it was raining and he was near it, so he got electrocuted instead. And so, you know, moving on into the future with technology, to explain it is that, you know, you get identified with your biometrics, right? Because of the electricity or something with him got fried, or something that made him change a little bit and alter, he doesn't get that same identification back. So he, you know, can't even go into his own doors, he can't log into his own account to play his game, and then he's like, I have to restart that is absolute BS. And so, you know, he's already cursing his bad luck, but because he has to, you know, make a living from the game, he has to do everything he can. And he goes, even if I have to remake a character and just become one of those peons and where I'm just like slave mining for the rest of my life, I have a family to support. And his family means that his little niece and his older brother, who's also on a wheelchair. So, you know, things are a little bit dire. But then, you know, you feel a little bit of attachment to that little bit of fact, but then it's more towards how the story starts shaping now, is that he logs on to the game. And it's like, you know, the game is like you have to register a new pattern or register a new account, register your new character. And he goes, I spent $800 something on this. This is my last one. So let's go. Let's get something. If I can get a mage, that'd be great. But, you know, highly chance that I'll get some scrubby kind of class. Could just be there. But then what happens then is that, you know, out of all the gacha cards that you get in the beginning, when you get this kind of like, you know, skills, when it comes to class, when it comes to items, like they don't really show you what it is. But the thing is for him now, it's like he has an open bug. He can see different color, and the colors like, you know, white, blue, green, red, purple, and orange, right? Red is obviously a really good class kind of spell, and then you got your purple, which is unique skill, and then you got your gold or orange, right? Basically, it's the best thing, and he can see it, right? He can't see what the card in the beginning of the class is, but like now, because he got electrified, and then somehow he can see all the bugs, is that he identified that out of all the pulls, all the gachas that you can pick, he saw an Archmage card. That class is one of the most OP one, right? And basically, he goes, this can't be right, can it? He goes, all right, you know what? Let's give it a try. So he grabs it and he changes into the 82nd or the 92nd Archmage in the whole wide world with all the people playing, right? He picked Archmage. And Archmage in this game means that you can learn all spells, right? All magic spells are at your disposal. And he's like, oh, that is insane. And then on top of that, he gains an massive amount of luck and everything that you can see because of this bug, right? And then all this bug is not detectable as well. So he started playing. And, you know, just to go through how amazing this story is and how light it makes you feel when you read it, it's like, imagine drinking a smooth whiskey. And it's just smooth straight. It goes down and you're like, ah, that went down really well. That's how Archmage Streamer Manhua it actually is. It's actually crazy. So to just really quickly get in, catching up to a little bit of speed is that, you know, he, you know, obviously starts the quest. He discovers the whole MS or main storyline, right? If you didn't know that, he basically starts the main storyline. He's the only one in the whole world that started the main storyline, according to where we are right now. And you know, he found patterns and he found you know, areas where he can start going through. And he actually understands why other people are getting all this awesome luck. And because he has that bug behind him, he's thinking, oh man, this guy, he's the only one that's able to tame this, you know, amazing wolf. Like, well, when am I gonna do it? And then he actually finds different kind of quest lines, different kind of things that he changes himself into a super OP Archmage that actually becomes really amazing. And now, you know, he obviously streams as well. He streams his experience because the title is called Archmage Streamer. So obviously it goes in like that and the story just becomes better and better and better. Now, I will have to tell you this, disclaimer, be warned that it is the biggest load of misunderstanding the story is, okay? The story is all about misunderstandings and people keep assuming and people keep on misunderstanding. It is a great thing. While that sounds hilarious, it is actually funny. So if you want a manhwa that is light, that is cheesy, that is also very relatable, and you just want to pass the time, please go ahead and pick up Archmage Streamer, and I'll tell you what, you will not be disappointed because it is an absolute amazing stuff. So yeah, very, very amazing stuff that I keep on watching and keep on reading. I really wanted to adapt into live animation, so it, you know, if the studio actually behind it makes this happen, it's all thumbs up for me. given a rating. It's a 4 out of 5 for me because it is very light, it's very easy. Some people might not be your cup of tea, but that's just the way it is. You have to judge it for your own. And for any gamers who likes this kind of thing, I think you'll like it as well. But I tell you what, that's gonna be it for me. If you still haven't hit that sub button, make sure to hit the sub button, like, notification bell completely run up. And of course, I will be streaming as well. If you do want to follow that, make sure to follow all the rest onto the other side. And I will see you in the next one. Let me know exactly what kind of manhwa you like, or manga or manhwa that you want me to explain, and we will go through that on the next one. This is Emperor CK signing off. Peace.